that's not the elevator, that's the restroom. Engineering. Let's see if these guys have anything new to say. Oh, what, our friend in the cargo bay, let's talk to her first. It's not that cargo bay, it's the other one.
Turians are nuts. A civilization of war nerds. Loyal viewers, but they write the creepiest fan mail.
Too funny. Girly is good, huh?
Whose mech was that? She has got some curves. Do we need to talk, Commander?
Get off of my ship. No, carry on.
Not right now, Allers. Let me know when we do.
Yeah, I'm just gonna, you know, push you out the airlock. It's all good. So Joker's not the only one who might be interested in the new Edie.
Nothing to report, Commander. Nothing to report, Commander.
Alright, alright. Well, there's no one else to talk to here. Well, it makes our crew updates quicker. For one thing. Shuttle bay. Show info. Shoulder plating with VI aim enhancement that targets enemy capabilities. Yeah, I'll take this. Ariaki technologies. Melee damage plus 10%. Shoulder plating with micro servos that coordinate melee strikes. You know what? I'm gonna forego that for the health boost. Hain Kadar. Leg plating with auxiliary power cells that feed into weapons. Who knew that armor could be such a good offensive item? Health boost is a lot less, though. You know, I'm gonna keep as is, because I really want the health for right now. Oh, that dog thing. Oh, here's a Cortez.
Ma'am. Ma'am. Ma'am.
Ma'am. Ma'am. Ma'am.
That Primarch's got some real cojones. What we need are more politicians like him, taking names and kicking ass.
Mm-hmm.
Hey. Hey.
Hey.
Hey.
Hey.
Hey.
Hey. Quick updates. Alright. You've got something suspicious? Sure, I've got a minute.
Commander, are you all right? It was fairly intense up here. I can only imagine what it was like down on that moon.
Oh, it was dreadful.
I thought you'd be more concerned about Edie.
Edie is a huge asset to this team. If she'd told me about her plan to obtain a body, I'd have volunteered to help.
I did not wish to force a conflict of interest between our friendship and your duty.
I'd have preferred a conflict of interest to a hard restart of half our systems. But thanks, regardless. While you're here, though, I found something while scanning Alliance channels.
Oh?
Grissom Academy is requesting help. The Reaper invasion front will hit them soon.
Oh, no kidding. Grissom Academy. That's where we sent... Tell me how I figure I remember this, because I'm terrible with names. And, like, people's names and names of things. David? Is that his name? From the, Overlord. Project Overlord. That poor guy who's autistic, if I have it right, was plugged into a VI network or AI network and could communicate with the Gath. But it was living hell for him. He was strung up and his eyes forced open and voices in his head nonstop, driving him insane. But yeah, Grissom Academy.
I thought the war would close most schools.
Grissom Academy is more specialized than a normal school. It's home to some of the smartest students humanity has to offer. Mm-hmm. Their Ascension project helps gifted young biotics. If it had been open 20 years ago, I bet you'd have been there.
Biotics?
Yes, I sent a young man named David Archer there.
David Archer.
I'm surprised they're still open.
Some of their work has Alliance support. That might be why they stayed.
I'd definitely like to help them.
What can we do?
A Turian evac transport responded to their distress call, so normally I'd say we don't need to do anything. But something sounded off in the Turian signal. I had Edie perform an analysis. It's fake.
Huh.
Edie thinks it's Cerberus. She said the fake Turian signal was similar to the one that lured you to a collector ship.
Oh.
Long story.
In any event, whoever faked the signal wants us to think Grissom Academy's being evacuated. But I believe they're still in danger.
That is nice work, and yeah, it doesn't make a lot of sense, and you really tied up all the ends, didn't you?
Good catch. Maybe you belong here after all.
If this really is Cerberus, hopefully this operation is something worth investigating. It could be simple disinformation.
Trainer, good catch.
Thank you, Commander.
Need to be a little more, I don't know. What's the word? I'm not thinking assertive. She needs to be a little more, No, she's very self-conscious of herself. See if you have any email. And that's not email. Well, we've got a bunch of stuff. Omega, come see me. Oh, from Arya to Lok. Shepard, I have something important to discuss with you. It's sensitive, so we'll need privacy. I'll arrange for that soon. In the meantime, come see me on the Citadel in the aptly named Purgatory. I have a few ideas for your war. Urgent message from Admiral Hackett. Commander, there's an Alliance researcher working on the Citadel named Dr. Garrett Bryson. I need you to meet with him right away. Dr. Bryson has uncovered important new information about Reapers that could have a direct bearing on the war. I'm officially directing you to support his efforts at the first possible opportunity. Please visit Bryson's laboratory on the Citadel at once. Is this address valid? Shepard, I've called and I've sent messages but gotten no response. With Earth's comm system out, I don't expect this will get through either, but I heard a rumor the Normandy docked here at the Citadel. Are you alive? I'm at Huerta Memorial Hospital under the name Tanner Nuara. Please excuse the moniker and this email's encryption. In my line of work, it is unwise to advertise my location, particularly when I am not in good health. It's not Ashley. We should meet before circumstances force us apart again. Thane. Excellent. Okay. Looking forward to meeting Thane again. Help request from Sender Blocked. That's a funny name, Sender Blocked. Almost like Cinder Block. Commander, my name is Jondum Bao. I am with Special Tactics and Recon. While some still have concerns about your past activities with Cerberus, many of us in ST and R took your warnings about the Reaper seriously. I'm reaching out to you because I have information that could tie agents with significant political power to the Reapers. Excuse me, if you have time to meet me in the Citadel Embassy, I'd appreciate your discreet assistance. Sincerely, Jondum Bao, STG, STNR. I wonder what the STG stands for. Me, a Spectre, from Ashley Williams. Commander. She's awake? Yay! I don't know how to say this. Udina wants me to be a Spectre. Crazy, I know. I'm not a big fan of Udina, but he can make the Spectre thing happen. He's pressing me for an answer, but I don't know what to tell him. I'm too sore to get out of bed, and this gets dropped on me? I told him I'd think about it. If you find yourself near the Citadel, drop by the hospital. I'm getting a little stir-crazy here. Ashley. Nice. Meet me in Purgatory. Which one was sent first? I have a proposition for you, Shepard. You won't want to pass it up. I'm in a nightclub on the Citadel called Purgatory. Don't make me wait too long, Aria. Well, she really wants us to meet her in Purgatory. Unless it's for two different things. Dr. Bryson on Citadel. Dr. Bryson is working on a classified project and needs help. Contact him in his lab on the Citadel or Grissom Academy investigation. Grissom Academy needs to be evacuated before the Reapers destroy it, but the ship coming to evacuate the Academy faked its signal. Investigate Grissom Academy and rescue the students if necessary. Okay. Hello? Joker? Getting used to your arm? EDN Joker.
Hey, Commander, check out my co-pilot!
Did you know about this?
So she installed herself into the new body without any help from you?
Come on, Commander, don't you trust me?
I don't know.
Let me put it this way. If I knew that Edie was going to install herself into a sexy robot body, do you honestly think I'd be able to keep quiet about it?
Yeah, probably
Look
not.
Look at that! I would have baked a cake.
I am right here, Jeff.
She can hear you.
Yes, you are, Edie. Yes, you are.
She actually looks... She looked uncomfortable. It is funny.
Hey, I know I used to rag on Garrus for being all angry, but I'm glad he's back. There's a whole lot of crap out there needs a bullet between the eyes. Plus, we might need something calibrated.
Okay, that's his line from the second one. I think I have to calibrate whatever the hell he would say. I have some calibrations to do or something. I'm glad he's back, too.
Commander? Commander?
Edie?
Hello, Shepard. Still getting used to greeting people in person? No. I require only one occurrence to adapt to a new concept.
Well, wow.
How are you adjusting to the arms and legs? I am interested to see how this body performs under real combat conditions. If I could accompany you sometime.
Absolutely.
Without stress testing, there is no way of knowing if it has serious design oversights. At the moment, it appears adequate.
That's not the word I'd use to describe you.
Perhaps we should speak privately.
I'll be over here, flying the ship.
Joker, watch where you're going. Don't fly us into a planet.
What's this about? Does Joker not like your new platform?
No, he approves. He wants me on the bridge. He says having me within visual range is important to his morale.
Right.
Shepard, do you believe your crew members should be allowed to disobey an order on moral grounds?
Disobey an order on moral grounds. What kind of order? I expect good judgment.
Absolutely. I have no use for team members who can't think for themselves. Why are you asking about something like that?
Yeah. I was designed by Cerberus. I do not take moral stances that conflict with orders from my executive officers. But when Jeff removed my AI shackles, I became capable of self-modifying my core programming. I asked Jeff if he thought I should change anything now that I can. He deflected the question with humor.
And you didn't get an answer.
Correct. He has repeated this pattern in response to several of my inquiries. Do you think I should make modifications?
He wants her to be some kind of sex bot. Not sure if dangerous. You choose your own path.
Only you can really answer that question. That's the point of free will.
But moral decisions should not be made in a vacuum. If I do not ask the crew for their opinion, I could miss crucial context.
What are you
May
thinking?
May I ask you the questions Jeff avoids?
Yes.
When there is time, will you answer them for me?
If you think it'll help, I'll do what I can.
This time
Very
now.
Very well. I will keep you informed.
Well, just tell me now. The suspense builds. Sex bot.
Yes, Shepard?
What modifications do you want to make? What are your capabilities?
Does that body have any useful advantages?
Very few. It's optics face forward only. It has no integrated weapon systems or anti-missile countermeasures.
I meant in comparison to organic bodies, not the Normandy.
Right.
Oh, I will reassess. The body is resistant to modern small arms fire and temperature extremes. Its balance and agility seem excellent. Its fine manipulation servos and software allow for precision tasks. I'm curious to see if I can alter them.
Actually, it's funny that she answered that way because I thought that's what Shepard meant as well. Versus, you know, being the AI all over the Normandy. Well, curiosity seems very organic. Normally you'd say very human, but wouldn't be appropriate in this case when we have all kinds of beings that are not human and have curiosity.
Can an AI be curious?
I am not entirely free from motivation, Shepard. Cerberus programmed me with several core functions that simulate desires. For example, my primary objective to keep the Normandy functioning is similar to your self-preservation instinct.
So how are you adjusting to the new body?
How's the new body working out?
It is interesting. The crew are approaching this platform to speak to me, even though they can do so anywhere in the ship.
Mm-hmm.
It's as if they wish to treat me as part of the crew. I am not, but this changes my perspective. I like it.
So you like things?
I didn't realize you had preferences.
I do not precisely enjoy something as you do, but my programming contains priorities. Actions that fulfill those priorities create positive feedback for me. I tell the organic crew that I like it. It is shorthand.
Yeah.
Will all this new feedback be too distracting?
Do not worry, Shepard. I only forget to recycle the Normandy's oxygen when I've discovered something truly interesting.
Joke.
That was a joke.
Like, come on, Shepard, you didn't see that coming. She'd joke like this back when she didn't have a body. Your work.
You look like you're in the middle of something. I am adapting the infiltration and sabotage programs this body uses for handheld firearms.
Why not download a firearms program from a security firm?
Because she knows what she's doing.
The fine motor control from the sabotage programs is more precise than standard mech software. It would be negligent of me not to exploit it to its fullest potential.
Well, you go on and experiment with it then.
So you're capable of making improvements on your own.
Well, you are experimenting.
Correct.
With whatever
the
she means.
The cyber warfare I was designed for is constantly evolving. Accordingly, I am programmed to seek out and assimilate new information. In organic terms, I want to learn.
She's a learning computer. The Normandy's escape.
How did you and Joker make it out of dry dock to rescue us?
Well, she got crafty. You do not want to get on her bad side, Commander.
When the Alliance commandeered the Normandy, I deceived their technicians. The crew did not tell them that I was a true AI. So the Alliance soldiers believed I still had VI programming constraints. I established the fiction that I would only respond to Jeff's commands, so they often brought him on board under guard.
Very crafty. So you deceived them, huh?
Wait. You can lie?
Jeff has freed me of Operator Control Shepard. No constraints forced me to give accurate data.
See that arm flame?
This was useful when the Reapers began landing. I could hack the control of the docking clamps and escape with Jeff inside. The soldiers guarding Jeff were willing to accompany us when Earth was invaded. They are watching over the war room now.
Yeah, we were in kind of a rush to get to you. Didn't seem right to just toss him out the airlock.
Huh.
Carry on, Edie.
Understood. If you wish to talk more, this body will be here. I'm getting the crew used to seeing me on the bridge.
Noted.
Commander?
His chair is a lot faster than it used to be. So these guys are hanging out in the war room. I wonder if I can talk to them.
Commander?
Primarch seems like a good guy. It is people moving in the right direction.
He's a good guy with his homeworld on fire. All he committed to is this war summit. A war summit we have to host since the Solarians won't even let a Proconaut on one of their ships.
Okay. Primarch's in here and whoever else. I'm guessing these are them, but there were people already here. Alright, let's talk to Primarch then.
Commander, thank you for allowing me the use of your ship, and for going along with this plan.
Oh, my
Garrett
pleasure.
Said he had to attend to the Normandy's weapon systems. Something about calibrations.
God.
Sounds like Garrus. I'm sorry to say the Asari counselor won't be joining us. She thinks there's too much bad blood with the Krogan.
She may be right, but there'll be a lot more blood. Real blood, if we don't try.
You know, these people think we have a choice.
The sooner we have this summit, the sooner we'll know. Mm. Is there something else I can help you with?
How's the situation on Palavin?
How are things on Palavin?
The casualty reports are staggering. The Reapers are using our own tactics against us. Destroy the enemy with overwhelming force.
I've seen the same on Earth.
That's their only strategy.
The strategist in me admires their brutality. The Turian in me knows I'm watching the destruction of 15,000 years of civilization. Mm-hmm. My civilization.
Yeah, I hope we can help them. Turian... I think it's a bad idea to ask this right after he's talking about his own homeworld being destroyed. Well, you gonna help Earth? Let's ask him about his duties next then.
How is it being the Primarch?
Not what I imagined. The battle of all time is happening on Palavin, and I'm light years away, reading casualty reports in the millions. If I'm going to die, I want to be with my men, so there's no doubt we fought to the last soul.
I can relate to that.
I understand. Leaving Earth to save it, it's one of the hardest things I've ever done.
I'm not surprised. Garrus speaks highly of you. You never asked to be a leader, yet your people will die if you refuse. We find ourselves in similar circumstances. Let's hope the spirits grant us the strength to see it through.
Okay. Speaking of strength to see things through, can a Turian see-through help for Earth?
I understand this is a difficult time for you, Primarch, but Earth can't survive without reinforcements. Can I still count on your help?
If the Krogan help us on Palavin, then I give you my word.
Thank you, Primarch. My thoughts are with Palavin.
And mine with Earth.
Okay. Rendezvous with a Salarian ship. Alright, not completely sure what we're doing next. But I want to thank you for watching. See you next time and endure. In enduring, grow strong.